Hey guys, this is Matt Beck from freesaloneducation.com here with American Salon at the IBS New York Hair Show, and I've got Mark Bustos with me. This was a surprise interview, so thank you, Gordon Miller, for that. But I'm really excited to just go over, because I know you have a huge message that you're delivering, so I would love for, if anybody in our audience doesn't understand your message yet, for them to understand that, because you're doing great things. So I know you've told this story 100 times. So what I want to do is I want you to tell me the important parts, how you decided to do what you're doing, and then we'll start there and kind of, you know, move forward.
Okay, so. Cool. So basically, I'm a hairstylist based out of New York City. I've been doing hair for about 17 years, since I was 14 years old. A couple years ago, I traveled out to the Philippines, and I knew I wanted to give back somehow. And hairstyling is my passion. I've never made a penny in my life that hasn't had to do with hair. So I figure, what better way to give back than with what I do best and what I love to do? So basically rented out a chair in a little barbershop in the province where my girlfriend's family is from, actually, and just rented out a chair in the barbershop and had homeless kids come in all day. And, you know, in America, thankfully, you don't see many homeless kids walking around the streets, but in developing third world countries, you do.
Right.
So I figured let's give back to the kids out there. And, you know, all day long we were cutting hair for the homeless kids right off the street. And you figure,
so
like,
how did you end up there? So you went there to visit?
I went to go visit some family.
Okay.
Both of our families are actually from the same province, about 45 okay. minutes away from each other.
Okay.
That's how it
So how long were you there doing that?
It was just a one day thing.
Okay.
I planned on just doing it for one day, and one day turned into every single week for 3 years now.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's so great. So tell me, so then you came back to New York and you decided to, every Sunday, right?
Yep.
So if I have the message correct, every Sunday you go out and you cut hair for homeless people all over New York City, or you've been traveling to other cities as well, right?
Been traveling to other cities. I just recently finished a trip cross country from New York to LA.
Wow.
I did homeless haircuts across the country in 11 different cities in about 2.5 weeks.
Yeah.
My next big-ish trip will be from up the Pacific coast, from San Diego up to Vancouver. So
okay.
I'll be in May coming up.
So, and this is something, I heard you speak at the Millennium Experience last year, right?
Yeah.
Was that last year?
Yep.
So, I thought the coolest part about the story, you're up in front of, you know, 500 to 1,000 people, and you're telling your story. But the one thing that really got to me was that most people, when they see a homeless person, the mindset isn't right. Like they don't look at them and say, how could I help them? They look at them and just say, how can I get away? Or, you know, like the mindset is wrong. So tell me, what was different in your thought process, and what made you say, did it start with the kids? Was that like the big thing? And you said, you know what, I want to do this for everyone.
Or, yeah, you know, it started with the kids in the Philippines, because like I said, you don't really see homeless kids in America. From the first kid that was sitting in my chair, I knew right away. I was like, wow, like the feeling inside of me right now, how could I stop? Like,
I can only, I have an 8-year-old son, so I can only imagine, like, I can't imagine him being homeless, or any kids for that matter.
Yeah.
So to see that was probably pretty intense.
Yeah, exactly. And you know, what I've learned over time in doing haircut after haircut on the streets and even in the salon is that whether I'm cutting a client in the salon or an individual out in the street, we all come from somewhere. We all have a story. No, we're not all alcoholics and drug addicts.
Right.
And there are a lot of alcoholics and drug addicts that have a home.
Right.
You don't have to be homeless to be an alcoholic.
Exactly.
Or
yeah.
have mental illness. Or, you know, unfortunately, people come across difficult situations in life, and which land them out on the streets. Not everybody is as fortunate as I am,
right,
having a home and growing up in a loving family. You know, not everybody has that growing up. So. You know, I use social media as my platform to be able to give people a voice, to show that they're from somewhere and to show that they have a story.
Yeah.
Because it could be anybody. It could be your grandfather or your father that can land on the streets, and there's no telling when it's going to happen. You know, it could really just happen to anybody.
So tell me your favorite, like, so you go out every Sunday, so you meet tons of people. So tell me, like, you know, like an inspirational thing that, like, something that really moved you when you were out there.
You know, I've told this a million times before, and I'm sure a lot of your viewers have probably heard it if they've heard my story. But, you know, the first person I reached out to in New York when I hit the streets, I cut this guy's hair, and he was really shy and soft-spoken, but really nice. And I was nervous to approach him at first because it was my first time doing it. Something inside of me pulled me towards him, and it wasn't me, because something just pulled me towards him, and I just started talking. And you know, we walked into the park and ended up cutting his hair. Long story short, when he was done with the haircut, I handed him the mirror. He looked into the mirror and he said, "Do you know anyone that's hiring? I want to get a job." I've never seen the guy since that day.
Wow.
And right then and there, I was like, this is something I need to continue to do, because even though people just say, oh, what's just a haircut going to do? I mean, any hairstylist can relate. It's never just a haircut.
Right.
You know, it's always way more than that.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a big deal when people get their haircut, no matter what. So tell me, so you go out every Sunday, and you, how many heads of hair do you cut?
You know, it
usually
all depends. I wake up on Sunday morning, and that's when I'll decide what neighborhood I want to hit.
Okay.
Just like you wake up and you decide what you want to eat for breakfast. You don't know 3 days before what you want for breakfast on Sunday morning.
Right.
So I just go with my gut feeling on Sunday when I wake up.
Okay.
And I'll pick a different neighborhood because they're, I mean, again, unfortunately, they're everywhere.
Yeah.
And it can range anywhere between, if I'm prepared for it, I'll approach a big group of people.
Right.
And I'll be cutting hair all day.
Right.
Until
I bet.
Excuse me. Until the sun goes down. And that's usually like my cutoff point. When the sun goes down,
okay,
there's no more light.
Right.
I do it outside in the daylight. And the reason I do it outside is so that people walking by can be inspired to do something. Not everybody has to be a hairstylist to do something. I mean, I just want to be able to inspire others to look past what we are normally looking at, you know, and just be able to open our eyes and be able to help one another.
Yeah. And so every Sunday when you're going out, do you see a lot of the same people? I feel like I would probably have tons of friends at that point. Like, they're probably looking forward to you coming, because I would think that that's a great part of their day.
Yeah,
know?
For sure. I mean, I go down to the Bowery every so often, and I become friends with a lot of the people down there. And it's funny, one day after I cut like 12 of them, one of the older gentlemen pulled me to the side and he said, "Hey, Mark, you know, like, if you ever need anything, you know, we're here for you. You're family now. So if you ever need anything, if we can ever do anything for you, you come to us."
That's great.
And I was like, wow, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's awesome. So did you, so now you're passing the message. You have this write up in American Salon, like you're using social media. What is the message that you would most like people to get from what you're doing? Because I guarantee you're not saying everyone should go out and do exactly what I'm doing. So what would you say, you know?
You know, I have a lot of people that reach out to me, email me, message me on social media saying, "Hey, I want to be part of the movement. Where are you going to be next week? I want to help you. How can I do this? I'll fly out to New York just to meet you. I want to hand out this and that with you." I'm like, my answer is, I don't need help.
Right.
I'm cool. I don't need help. There's a lot of people out there that need help.
Right.
The way you can help me is by going out there and doing it wherever you are.
Like,
I don't need any publicity around me. I don't need any of that. I just want to be able to inspire people to just do good wherever they are. And it's beautiful to be part of an organization or a church or a group or whatever you want to be part of. But at the end of the day, if you want something done, just go out and do it. Because if you sit around and wait for someone, it's not going to happen.
Exactly. Yeah. And you're out there, you're doing it. And a lot of people, like, so what would be your advice, like, for anybody that's going out to do it? Because you say you go to different cities all the time. Is it, when you go to a new city, is it nerve-wracking for you to, are you getting like just me to go up to anybody, any person, anywhere right now and talk to them about anything is a challenge for me, right? So, which is weird why I'm in the hair industry or why I'm having this talk here. For some reason, in front of a camera, I'm fine. In real life, it's hard for me to go up to people. So people that are like that, you seem like maybe a little bit of a quieter person.
For sure. I'm a pretty shy person, believe it or not.
Yeah. So what would you say, like, what gets you to, like, what's your one line when you walk up to somebody to help them out?
The first thing I say when I go up to anybody is, "I want to do something nice for you today."
Okay.
That's it. Those simple words.
Okay.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
So, all right. So then, and you're using the social media platform. How has social media kind of helped push this forward?
Yeah, social media is the largest free public space out there.
Yeah.
Originally I started doing haircuts out on the street because it's a public space and I want to inspire people in the public space. But like I said, it's the biggest public space out there, and you can reach anybody in the world. And that's what's happened. I've been able to travel around the world because of the fact that social media, my story kind of just went viral through not only social media, but through news and everything. And, you know, what I've learned through my travels is that no matter where you travel to, no matter where you are on earth, Giving and receiving a haircut is a universal language, even if you don't speak the same language.
Right.
You don't have to be able to understand each other verbally, because if you're an educated hairstylist, you can understand what hairstyle works for that individual, no matter where you are in the world. And that's right. Just going to put a smile on people's faces.
That's awesome. Yeah. So, I mean, if you guys out there are not following Mark, then how can they follow you?
You can find me at Mark Bustos on both Instagram and Twitter. I really like to share everyone's stories on Instagram just to show that everybody comes from somewhere and everyone has a story. And I just want to continue to inspire other people to just do good by one another.
Well, you're doing it. I mean, anyone I ever talk to, you're such a good person and you're doing things, and you can tell, like, pre cameras, pre anything, like you want the message to be out there. There wasn't anything else. Like, I sit down with people to talk to them all the time, and there's usually some kind of agenda. Yours was very, like, I just want my message out there.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I've been doing hair for a long time, and I've always looked for success in the hairstyling world. And, now that I'm charging top dollar for a haircut, I just realized that, like, I say this all the time, too, is that you're either expensive or you're free, never cheap. And
right.
That's where I found my success, is that if you love what you do so much, you're going to be so good at it that you'll be able to do it for free and be happy doing it.
That's awesome. Awesome. Well, best of luck to you with everything that you're doing.
Thank you. It's awesome.
Definitely follow Mark. You're going to be inspired completely. And let's help push this movement and, share your stuff that you're doing to help people out there as well. Mark, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you to American Salon for hooking us up with this interview and this table at this great hair show, IBS New York. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video. Thanks.